What's good, YouTube? It's me, your boy Squiddy, back again with another video. And today we have a very special guest on the channel giving us his deck profile. He just top 8 at the YCS Remote Duel that just happened over the course of the past weekend. We have here Kenny Nguyen, who actually has multiple tops, very well known in the community. He's got a Nationals top 4 as well, and he actually went to Worlds, the World Championship in 2017, believe it or not. So yeah, without further ado, I will pass it over to you, Kenny. Anything you want to say, any shout outs you want to do before the video starts, before the deck profile?
Yeah, I'll give some quick shout outs. Well, first shout out to you for like hyping me up. I mean, I appreciate that. But I would like to shout out to my team right here, TCG. I'd also like to shout out to Sunny Hobbies, local store in Toronto, Canada. Shout outs to my Discord server, the Gatekeepers. And then also shout outs to my Twitch channel. It's twitch.tv/KennyYGO. I'm top 10 on DB right now, pretty much playing the deck here, and I go over a lot of the plays and the lines that like can't all be covered in this video, so it'd be nice if you guys check it out. And yeah, that's about it for the shoutouts, and I'll show you the profile.
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay, all right. So for the monsters, played obviously Pure Sprite, so 3 blues, 3 jets, red, carrot, pretty standard here. I see most people plays ratio right now. I don't like pixies or like any more of the copies because they just fill up slots that could have been non-engine if you play those cards. And I think you just need to see a hand of a lot of non-engines right now to beat a Shizu tier because the deck is just so powerful that you kind of have to make some sacrifices. So the minimal amount, it's fine. Other monsters played 3 swap, 3 beaver, 2 angler, pretty standard ratios for everything here. Second angler to send off of sprint. A lot of people ask me why I play 3 swaps actually over 2, because you only really need 2 to make the toad. But I found that a lot of times you need 3 because it lets you have a target for smashers, which is like really important, because when you end on your board of like toad, elf, and even red, none of those cards on the field is something you really want to smashers. So having this body on the field is like really, really nice. And that's why I ended up playing 3 swaps. It comes up a lot.
You never really bricked on it or anything, like seeing 2 swaps? Kind of. I guess you could summon it, but...
Yeah, it's a little bit kind of bricky, but what's nice is you can draw swap along with angler is really good. Swap plus swap is really good post-side 2 to play around gamma, just because another summon. But yeah, I still think the third isn't really necessary because a very common play against tier is you'll just do your combo, right? You'll go uninterrupted. And then on their turn, they'll first action play planet. And you really don't want to toad negate that because they can play another one. But you really want to smashers it because then everything else will be chain blocked. But if you don't have a third one, then you can't really smashers anything on your field. And that just comes up way too much, I think. And then for the hand traps, it's Bestial Sprite. So obviously got your Bestial cards, 3 Magnemite, 3 Druid Swarm, and 1 Sorinir. So ended up this ratio because I was playing multiple Sorinirs before, but I ended up putting it to 1 only because it was searchable from the Magnemite. When I was playtesting, what ends up coming up a lot is that I was always needing to use Druid Swarm's actual effect because it helps break boards, which is like really relevant because what I like to do a lot with Druid Swarm is use its effect after resolving Gigantic Sprite. So you can clear tier boards pretty easily with like this card because then they can't fusion summon even if you kill like a floater, anything like that. And then the main usage of this that I think is that it's an instant out to Baguska because you just special it, normal summon something, link it to a link 2, and this can pop to Baguska. And anytime you play against tier, if you hand trap them a lot, they'll try to like make Baguska so that they can play again next turn, and the Druid Swarm just outs that. So I found myself a lot of times realizing that I needed specifically Druid Swarm as my Bestial, and that's why I ended up just not playing like multiple Sorinirs, because it's very specific that a lot of times it just has to be Druid Swarm. It can't be like a random Bestial. But I played obviously the ones because it's searchable if I already have this in my hand.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. So I guess at the end of the day, the value of having the Druid Swarm effect just outweighs like breaking on multiple copies.
Yeah, because like sometimes you'll draw like multiple Bestial cards, but like it doesn't have an effect like Sorinir. And I realized that actually came up a lot like in practice over theory. Yeah. And then 3 Ash, generic, good against flu. 3 Skullmeister, and then 3 Impermanents. This is standard and permanence. Hit Kit Kali was really good. Overall Hand Trap, Flew Under, pretty good. These were available before, but I threw them back to Skullmeisters because in the tier mirror, or in the tier matchup, resolving Kelbeck and Aikido against your deck is just game. So I just needed another layer to stop that, and this was like the only card that really did that. So it was really good.
Yeah, that's fine. I guess you can use it on your turn too. Go second.
Comes up. Yeah. No, the card's really good because like it was Valor before, but yeah, just Kelbeck and Aikido. And obviously three starters, the Prosperity, and then two Smashers. Played the two because when you're playing against tier, they mill your deck a lot, so you always want one left in your deck because it's like the cleanest out to like big monsters. You don't really want to go to your extra deck or go out of your way in your extra deck to like out like a single card when you can just Smashers it.
Nice.
All right, that's the main deck.
I guess I forgot to ask at the beginning of the video. Was there any reason you chose to play Pure Sprite as opposed to like tears or?
Oh no, I've just been playing Pure Sprite ever since it came out, and it's pretty much the only deck I own. And I feel like the tier mirror is a little bit complicated if you start a little bit late. So I didn't feel like I had an edge against anyone else because I just started. I started playing Sprite, and if I were to pick up tier about like 2-3 months later, I felt like I was just gonna be behind everyone else. That's pretty much why I ended up playing Sprite, even though it's clearly not the best option.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense.
I'll do extra first. All right. So extra played Wallow, Cat Shark, Omimaru, Jin, Zeus Package, Gigantic, Toad, and then these are my links. Everything seems pretty standard here. This is a new edition, I think. I don't see people play this, but this is just it has pretty much no effect. It's just a 2300 link 2, and it outs Baguska. And literally, like I was saying before, Baguska seems to be like the problem this deck like always has. So this is a very clean out to link 2, so you can keep playing after 2 if you have Red or Carrot. I summon this a lot because everyone was making Baguska against me. It's definitely needed if you're going to play this.
Yeah, obviously it's better than Cerberus because anyone worth their salt would just put it in the extra monster zone so you can't even Cerberus pop.
Yeah, yeah, that happens so much where like they would put it in the extra monster zone, so you just need specifically this card. And everything else is pretty standard, I think. All right, and then side. Gammas, good in the mirror, Flunder. Nothing to say. Shifter,
probably shifter a lot
needs to go. No, actually, I only shiftered 3 people. And one game I actually lost when I shifted. Funny enough, this card is a little bit weird to use in this deck because anytime you shifter them, they will try to end on Maguska, and then you can't play either. And I think, so it's funny to say that this card is hard to use, even though it's probably the most brain-dead card, or most people would think it's a brain-dead card to use, right? Like, huh, shifter, you know, can't play macro. But I think it's actually one of the more difficult cards to use, because what a common mistake I see people do is their tier opponent will start off activating Shiren effect, and that's their first action, and they'll chain shifter, which I think is incorrect, by the way. And the reason why I think it's incorrect when you do that is because you give them a free level 4 in the body. So even if you shifter them, all they have to do is go planet, summon Rhino Heart, summon Kelbeck, summon Aikido, summon Medora, summon whatever, and then W Baguska, and then you just can't play, right? So what I usually like to do with that is I'll hold the shifter in my hand, I'll let them mill, let them fuse into Kit Kalos, and then when they target Kit Kalos itself, then I'll chain this. So what that does is it gets rid of the level 4, it gets rid of the Kit Kalos, and then they start milling, and now they don't have a free 4 to make Baguska as easily. And I think that decides a lot for me, like winning and losing. So it's a common mistake a lot of people do with shifter, and I think that's what
really
I do.
Clever. See, I didn't even think about that. I mean, I was still thinking that, you know, it'd be correct to shifter on Sharon because a lot of people are doing that to me still. So, but no, that makes a lot of sense. They commit.
Yeah, I also think that's like a big difference of why I think I did better than most people, because a lot of people just like use this off the rip and then they lose and then they're like, I cannot Baguska, but you want to wait until they get rid of the resources, so.
Yeah, that's really awesome.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then Three Nibiru, not popular right now, but every time I was playing this deck in particular, I would always feel like if they had Nib, I would lose. So I ended up playing it because if I think that, then other Sprite players will think that too. So this card was basically just for the mirror. It's really good right now because they don't go Gigantic Sprite anymore. They always go into Sprint, send Angler, summon two Beavers, and then you nip them. And that's really good.
That makes a lot of sense. You just basically decimate the entire board for one hand trap, where previously in the old format, you needed nib plus like another hand trap.
Last format, you needed like nib plus something else. But nowadays, it's just like every player plays in their mind like no one plays nib, so they play into it, and it's like really, really strong against the mirror now. Like, you can just draw this alone and win, like you said.
Yeah, really unexpected.
Mm-hmm. And Harpies, new Cosmic, and then a Double Cross for going first, and then just stuff for flu, general macro stuff.
Do you also side in Cosmics against Tier Limits going second and all?
Yes, I do. My side in against Tier Limits is 3 Cosmic and 3 Shifter. And this is what I side in. Yeah, it's really good because a lot of times hitting Solia, Crime, and potential Floodgates, like there can be only one, or Skill Drain that they play, is really good.
Yeah, that makes sense.
And yeah. That's it for the profile.
That is really, really awesome. Yeah, a lot of great tips here. I totally wouldn't have thought. Is there anything else you want to talk about in the tournament or the deck?
No, I think I covered it pretty well for the most part. I think I explained things that like aren't normal, I would say, about the deck, like the holding shifter and all that. And I think that made the difference between me doing really well versus other Sprite players.
Yeah, I was going to say, I think that made all the differences. That's why you were the one Sprite player that could make it so deep into the tournament.
Yeah, that's probably why, right?
Yeah, congrats once again, Kenny. And again, guys, I'll post his Twitch channel in the description below, so definitely check that out. He's going to be streaming and giving more in-depth tips that you normally wouldn't see in the Yu-Gi-Oh! Community. These are very top-secret tips, so definitely check them out. And if you haven't already, rate, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one.
All right, cool.